The elaborate phase provides opportunities for students to apply and extend their conceptual understanding in a new context incorporating Indigenous perspectives. Students extend their knowledge of plants and their use by Indigenous people to construct a Maya Maya shelter. Students plan and conduct a science investigation about the properties of materials and use local plants to develop understanding of the science and technology used by traditional Indigenous people.
We're ready to start doing our investigation. We have our page set up in our class journal, science journal. Our focus question is, what affects the strength of glue? And we have a variable grid set up there, and that's what we're going to be using for our investigation. So we're going to move into our cooperative groups.
Students are supported to plan and conduct an open investigation. Information and communication technologies and multimedia representations support students to plan investigations and record their findings. Predictability is important for students. Teachers model and roleplay task requirements, use of equipment, and appropriate behaviours.
The manager will need to also come and collect a variable grid for everybody.
What are we? We're changing the glues. Types of glue.
Indigenous perspectives are considered in order to plan and conduct an investigation into the properties of natural min glue compared with commercially manufactured glues.
Sap?
Yeah, that's sap, but that's only when it's hard. But when it is first on the tree, it's really, really runny. This is the main ingredient because this is the sticky stuff.
Local Indigenous community members share their knowledge of bush glue, and students investigate the proportions of kangaroo scats, ash, grass tree resin and water needed to make effective natural adhesive.
We don't need more glue now.
We need more ash.
Do we?
I don't know.
We need more charcoal.
Now you've had the chance to make your natural glue, Jaden, and you've tested your natural glue. You're going to test the strength of that against three different manufactured glues because you're going to be testing the strength of these glues and comparing it with the strength of the natural glue.
We're looking at what happens when the water goes on some pavement around the school. You can write pavement on your water surface in that first column. We're looking at what happens when we put water on the sand. Does it stay there? Does it go somewhere? What does it look like? What does the sand look like? Same with the soil. Pouring the water onto the soil, what happens to it? We're going to pretend that this white cup's a rain cloud and we're going to put water into the cup. So here's our rain cloud. We're going to put water in our rain cloud and then we're going to pour the water onto different surfaces. If you've got anything to ask me, who's going to come over and ask me? The speaker, well done.
We're going to write what really happens.
What we really observed, well done. First of all, we're going to have a look at on the soil. Then we're going to have a look at on sand. What happens to rain when it falls on sand? What happens to rain when it falls on the sand? What happened on the sand?
What does it do?
Certainly going down.
It's like a hill as such, but instead of obstacles in the way, it's more smoother.
It is smooth too. Can you imagine having a water pipe down here? Would it be easy for the water to run down to the houses?
Maybe.
Maybe?